الحمد لله ما دام الوجود له حمدا يبلغنا منه الرضا أبدا، ثم الصلاة على المختار سيدنا وآله الكرماء وصحبه الزهدا.
بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. أما بعد، so today and tomorrow we're gonna use Quranic du'as to go to a separate topic that is related to the concept of du'a. And I begin by quoting the du'a that we'll be doing today. Surah Al-Qasas, verse 24. Surah Al-Qasas, verse 24. It is the famous du'a of Musa عليه السلام. قال ربي إني لما أنزلت إلي من خير فقير. قال ربي, he said, oh my Lord, إني لما أنزلت إلي من خير. Any good that you send down to me, oh Allah, I am faqir, I am a beggar, I am muhtaj, I am miskeen. I have nothing, oh Allah, except what you send down for me. قال ربي, إني لما أنزلت إلي من خير فقير. First, let's look at the concept and the context of this dua, and then it will lead us to the topic of using certain phrases in the dua and certain circumstances to increase the power of our dua. The context of this dua is the famous story of Musa alayhi salam fleeing from Fir'aun when he accidentally hit the Egyptian and accidentally killed him. And the people of Fir'aun said, oh, you are a murderer, we're gonna, you know, take you to task. And so he fled. And as Allah says, فَخَرَجَ مِنْهَا خَائِفًا يَتَرَقَّبُ. He fled the city trembling and scared. And remember, at this stage, Musa was not yet a prophet. He was simply a believer, a Muslim. He hadn't been appointed a prophet. He's been a young man raised in the house of Fir'aun. And he knows he's an Israelite. He knows he's Bani Israel. But culturally, language-wise, upbringing, he is with the elite, the creme de la creme. This accident takes place and Fir'aun uses it to turn against him. And Fir'aun then gives the order to execute Musa. So Musa flees without any preparation. No baggage, no wallet, no cash, nothing. He is in the middle of the street. Somebody comes and says, oh Musa, right now the leaders of the Fir'aun's army are going to come and capture you. Right then and there he fled. فَخَرَجَ مِنْهَا خَائِفًا يَتَرَقَّبُ. And he left with only the clothes on his back. And he didn't even know where he's going. And he goes from town to town, village to village, until he reaches the land of Midian, which is in the Sinai Peninsula. So he goes to Midian. وَلَمَّا وَرَدَ مَاءَ مَدْيَنَ. When he got to the well of Midian, he's thirsty, he wants water, and there's a public well that he can have access to. He hasn't had food, he hasn't drunk for Allah knows how long. When he gets there, he sees a very strange scene. And that scene is a lot of shepherds, young men with their flock, and they're jostling and shoving, fighting one another to get food for their flock, to get water for their flock. And away from them, there are two ladies with a small group of sheep as well. So he says to them, what is the matter? ما خطبكما? What is your story? What are you doing here? قالتا لا نسقي. They said, we as ladies, we can't go into this crowd, this melee of men hustling and bustling. We're not going to jump in there. We have to wait our turn until they finish. There's no water left. Whatever is left, we will get it for our flock. Our father is elderly. We cannot afford a hired hand. So we are forced in our circumstances to stand in line and wait for our turn. What is very powerful here, Musa himself being at this point in time a pauper. He doesn't have a penny to his name. At this point in time, he doesn't have anything. Yet still, he finds a way to be charitable. In fact, he is a refugee. And he is fleeing persecution. And he has nothing to offer except the sweat of his brow. He can give it to them. The one act of charity that he can give is to literally, physically, manually labor a few minutes on behalf of people who are strangers by blood, by religion, by ethnicity. And this shows us the benefits of righteousness. When you are righteous to others, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala returns that favor back to you manifold. Musa, having nothing, still manages to give. And when he gives this act of charity, that he goes in and he feeds their flock without any thanks, he doesn't need anything from them. And it is very important to point out that these ladies, culturally, ethnically, and religious-wise, have nothing to do with Musa. He literally was charitable to a complete stranger, and he did not expect any reward from them. Also, I remind you, he was not yet a prophet. He was your average Muslim. He was a Muslim. He believed in Allah. He's from the Bani Israel. They believe in the teachings of Ya'qub and Ishaq. He's from their progeny. He knows Allah. He knows the religion, but he is not yet a prophet. And so from the good nature that he has, despite all of the problems, can you imagine his own mental state? Can you imagine what he's worried about? He doesn't even know where he's going to sleep. He doesn't know where he's going to get food. But still, he finds an act of charity and he gives whatever he can. And he hands the flock back, and then ثُمَّ تَوَلَّ إِلَى الظِّلِّ, having nowhere to go, tired from running away from Egypt, tired and hungry, disheveled and dusty, he goes under a tree. And all alone, from the depths of his heart, he makes this dua. Ya Rab, I'm a faqir. I'm a faqir, Ya Rab. I have nothing. But I want everything you can give me, and I will always be grateful. قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي لِمَا أَنزَلْتَ إِلَيَّ مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَقِيرٍ. And this dua, what happened then? Immediately, فَجَاءَتْهُ. The fa means immediately after that. One of these two young ladies came back, shy, awkward. She said, my father heard what you did. We told him what you did. He wants to thank you. Can you come back with me? And so he goes back, and within a few hours, he gets a job. He gets a roof over his head. He gets food and drink for many, many years. He gets a career. And to sweeten the deal, he gets a wife as well, mashallah, tabarakallah. Those of you that are single, I joke, stand outside and feed water, and inshallah, we'll make dua for you. Inshallah, it will happen. Those of you that are single, not those that are already married, that doesn't work then, okay? So the point is that this dua was made, and we get to our quick topic, and we'll continue this topic tomorrow. This dua was made after performing a good deed. And this leads us to the topic. In Arabic, it is called tawassul. And tawassul means that you use something to make your dua more powerful so that it reaches Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So tawassul means you maximize the efficiency of your dua. You add something that will make it more effective. And there are many mechanisms of tawassul. This dua teaches us the first that we'll do, and we'll continue today and also tomorrow, as I said. Number one, tawassul is done through your own righteous deeds for the sake of Allah. You do a good deed for the sake of Allah. You are allowed to use that deed to magnify the effect of a dua. You do a good deed, you give charity, you help somebody in need. Then you say, oh Allah, I also need help from you. You're using your good deed to make your dua more powerful. And this is explicitly mentioned in the hadith in Sahih Bukhari. Very long hadith, the quick summary of it is, one day, three people of the old, previous generations, they were stuck in a cave. An avalanche happened and the cave was shut. Three people were there and they were going to starve to death. And they were righteous people. The three said to one another, only a miracle can save us. Let us make dua to Allah. And the most knowledgeable said, each one of you, make dua to Allah and mention the one best deed that you've ever done. And then ask Allah to remove the rocks in front of the cave. So the long hadith tells each one of them stood and made dua to Allah. Each one of them mentioned one good deed and the rocks moved a little bit, then a little bit. And then in the third time it moved so that they could go out. The first one mentioned a deed that he showed, the sacrifice he made for his mother and father. It's a long hadith, I can't tell you all of it because of time, but he made a big sacrifice for his parents and he preferred his parents over his own family. And he said, oh Allah, if I did this for your sake, then help us. So Allah moved a little bit of the rocks. The second man, it was a question of honesty. He could have acquired a lot of wealth in an illegal manner, in an unethical manner. But he said, oh Allah, no one forced me, but I did it for your sake. I was honest and I gave this man a fortune for your sake, even though I could have gotten it on my own pocket. So he was honest and he used that. So it moved a second time. And the third was the case of a man who wanted to take advantage of a young lady. Eventually the young lady, for her circumstances, she was forced to, but she said, fear Allah and don't do this. And so even though he had paid the money, he said, oh Allah, just because of you, then I did not do that deed. So these three men, they made this dua and the rocks moved until they were able to walk out. The point is, one of the mechanisms of tawassul is you can use a good deed in your dua to Allah. Like Musa, he's done the good deed, and he can then either in your heart or you can mention it. Either in your heart you think of, oh Allah, that day I needed the money, yet I saw the beggar and I gave to that beggar. Oh Allah, if I did it for your sake, then oh Allah, I ask you that this dua of mine, you grant me it. This is a legitimate tawassul, and it is a permissible tawassul. And this also means, my dear brothers and sisters, we should have a good amount of deeds in our wallet we can pull out when we need to. Right? When we need to, we should have a good amount in our minds. Oh, I've done this, I've done that. So that when we need to use tawassul, we can then mention it in our dua. We can then say, oh Allah, I did such and such for your sake. Oh Allah, please give me this. And also in the Quran, so many du'as mention, رَبَّنَا إِنَّنَا آمَنَّا فَغْفِرْ لَنَا. Oh Allah, we have believed, therefore forgive us. So you mention the good deed. I have faith, oh Allah, therefore forgive. Allah, رَبَّنَا اكْشِفْ عَنَّا الْعَذَابَ إِنَّا مُؤْمِنُونَ. Oh our Lord, we are believers, so remove the punishment from us. So we use the good deed of faith, the good deed of charity, the good deed of any of these things that we have mentioned. Any good deed can be used. This is the first issue of tawassul. The second that we'll mention from the same dua over here, or the same concept over here, of the mechanisms of tawassul that is allowed, is to mention in your dua the pitiful state that you are in. You're in a bad state, you're in a dire situation. You may make a point of mentioning your situation. Musa says, I'm a faqir, oh Allah, I have nothing. He's using his state to appeal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nuh alayhi salam, he's surrounded by his people, he's gonna be killed. So Nuh says, قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي مَغْلُوبٌ فَانْتَصِرْ. Oh my Lord, I'm gonna be conquered, I'm gonna be vanquished. I need your help against my enemies. So he's making dua to Allah, إِنِّي مَغْلُوبٌ. I am gonna be gone unless you help me. Likewise, a number of other incidents occur as well. We have the story of Zachariah as well. Zachariah, when he is very old, 120 years old, they say 130 years old, he doesn't have a son, he doesn't have a child. So he says, قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي وَهَنَ الْعَظْمُ مِنِّي وَاشْتَعَلَ الرَّأْسُ شَيْبًا. Oh my Lord, my bones are fragile, they're gonna crack at any second. My hair is sprouting white. Look at my pitiful state, O Allah. Look at my pitiful state. I am so old, I'm about to die, and my lineage is going to be fizzled out unless you bless me with a child. So bless me with a child, O Allah. So what does Zachariah use? What did Nuh use? What did Musa use? They're using their pitiful state. It's something that should elicit sympathy in a human being. How much more so in Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim? So we can mention, O Allah, you know I'm in financial difficulty. Oh Allah, you see that I'm surrounded by problems. Oh Allah, you know I have no one other than you. This is a mechanism of tawassul that we put inside the dua. وَقَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي لِمَا أَنزَلْتَ إِلَيَّ مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَقِيرٍ. So these are two mechanisms of tawassul. We will inshaAllah ta'ala continue tomorrow and mention other mechanisms of tawassul. Until then, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
نبي سلام عليك يا رسول سلام عليك يا حبيب سلام.